OSM is a quite positively saying very very top down. Very very clarify operator how what kind of service requirements or feature is expected from an operator's point of view and enforce to the whole community. It's quite a big challenge though, and so far it works so very well. And that's one thing. And as Franz Kleiber mentioned, so we are seriously taking account how to realize the production ready. It's a big challenge. And in the NFV and the NFV journey is almost 5 years. So many of a couple of operators got together in here in Santa Clara, no, in San Jose in the 5 years ago, and established NFV in 4 years and a half. And the first meeting was in 2013, January. That's almost 4 years and a little. And it takes a long time, and still we are thinking so what the reality is. And given that, so both of the vendor community and the operator community, it's quite difficult to continue to spending your resources and the money and the time and the so on for long years. So that's why OSM community seriously take into account to how to make it business and how to get their money. And vendor community need to get their money from an operator, and the operator need to get the money, additional money from a customer. And without such a more real business ecosystem, it's quite difficult to sustain forever, whatever they want. And many people say now open source is very a trend, and some people and analysts saying that that's fragmented. But I would say I don't think so, because open source is always quite natural and good, healthy nature in such a way to everyone some try do something and do something, listen, learn. That's, we seriously, consider that's necessary, not only just, table discussion in the NFV, but also some hands-on engineering, what the problem is and what the reality is to make it happen. So that's Franz Kleiber mentioned. So that's, one of the nature which advisory group, OSM EUAG stand for End User Advisory Group. All the operator is gathering the what's the real requirements from a business point of view, not a technical point of view. And then such a UAG community is input as a strong requirement, what need to be addressed in the release one and the following two and three. And given that, as Fabi mentioned, this coming release three is a seriously more carrier grade production ready. So that's why compared with the legacy open source community, is everything is a very strongly top-down approach is now working. And I just slipped, please take a look at this materials after this conference. Maybe you can download it from my website. So because my time is over, and all the information almost covered by. But still, community is looking for what's next. Of course, near-term strategy must be production and real business. But the more middle and long-term, some evolution or vision should be also very qualified from operator community and EUAG. So that's one of the things is automation. It's not surprise to everyone, because nowadays everyone say that automation is very key. And of course, it's still far away, but at the end, so what's the reality and what's the real expectation from NFV and SDN will be how to make it easier in the daily operation and how to agile in the 5G era, like network slicing and edge computing and so on. So everything should be automated. So that's a vision, and now advisory group is now discussing internally and how advisory group and the operator group can indicate so what's next and beyond. And this one is just the business cases, and I just briefly explain. Because given that each operator has a totally different business model and network service model, like VNF as a service and NFV infrastructure as a service and so on. So that's why each operator gathering what's the real business cases which each operator take into account. And then more dig into corresponding service requirements. At the same time, that's a hands-on lesson learned compared with the legacy standard activity, be a more interactive way. And also some people say that which one is more important, either a standard or open source. But my answer is very clear. So everything is very important because everything should be more collaborate each other and interact with each other. And Javier mentioned one of the good things for OSM community was is still ongoing. Once lesson learned from a hands-on engineering, then feedback to HNB. And then HNB can more improve or enhance their spec and the state to and state C specification, and then feedback to the open source community again. So those kind of more looping and recursive feedback is very necessary at the end. And this one is also same, just a little bit. And one of the question is the security, because given that without the security serious consideration, it's impossible to production ready. And you know, as he mentioned, even security is a very high level, a very, very broader world, but so many bunch of the different levels of the security is necessary to be addressed and realize that, even in the open source shield code. So that's why in the operator group is now get together and how to differentiate and how to distinguish and how to figure out all the necessary security level of future requirements for coming release 3. And the next step is, Fabio already a little bit mentioned. So what operator group and advisor group is now doing is to gathering all the operators' requirements, serious business requirements and expectation, and then prioritize what's the most highest priority and what's the next. Because with such a limited time, we cannot address everything at the same time. So that's why we are now prioritized. Like you know, enabling a network service instance to save state, and the performance management is also very critical, and auto-scaling and affinity and anti-affinity for VNF deployment, and what kind of you know fault management, including a platform recovery, everything should be addressed for production ready, and then our expectation in the coming release 3 will be. OSM hands-on result and outcome can be leveraged in part of the RFQ or RFP in by operator. Anyway, still over the 10 minutes, but if you have any question or any interesting to what kind of a spreadsheet is now there, maybe I can show you, and please contact with me. I'm not the chair of advisory group, but Andy Reid from British Telecom. Unfortunately, he is not coming here today. So that's why on behalf of Andy, so I'm presented. Thank you.